Yes. Sweater. Tie. Perfect. Okay. Well, exercise 2, it says complete the color words in the box. So this is about the colors. The first color that we have is red. Number 2. Yellow. 3. Okay. 4. Purple. 5. White. Excellent. 6. Orange. Correct. 7. Blue. 8. Green. 9. And then. Perfect. Okay, now we have a chart with some questions. So let's see. I'm going to start with Perla. Okay, this question is just for Perla. What colors do you like to wear? Blue, pink, purple. Okay, Luis, what colors are you wearing right now? Blue and black. Okay. Danny, what colors do you never wear? Green, really? Okay, Luis, what colors are in your home? White, green, and brown. Okay, Daniela, what colors are your favorites? Purple and brown. Okay, Perla, what colors are popular right now? Yellow, pink. Yes. And Luis, what colors are in your country's flag? Green, white, and red. Okay, so let's continue with the second part here. Okay, we have in exercise 3, two conversations. Number 1, this between Lena and the clerk. They're going to complete this conversation with this, that, this, or those. Let's see. Well, in this case, only Lena. So, Perla, can you tell me the answers for the conversation 1? Lina says, oh, and how about? Those shoes, excellent. And the second part, and what about? Those t-shirts. What do you think? Okay, you're seeing those shoes. Pay attention. We have Lina. So here are the shoes are over there. But pay attention to the t-shirts. They are here. Johnny has to do this. Okay? And she can touch the shirts. Pay attention, the word is plural. What do you use when you touch? Is, yes. If you pay attention, she is close. She is close to the racket. Okay, so number two, we have Tink and the seller. Okay, Luis, you're going to be Tink, and Daniela, you're going to be the seller. So the first part, Luis, what is your answer? How much are... those umbrellas, okay. And the seller says, Danny, sorry. This umbrella. And the second line. Excellent. And Luis, the last part. So I want this umbrella too. Okay, correct. Now let's move to the exercise B. So here we have, it says, look at the pictures and write questions and answers. Number one, how much are those scarves? Well, we have the price over there. So in letter B, what do we need? It's or there? For number one B. It's or there? There, correct. Okay, number two. Okay, this is for Luis. Question and answer, please, Luis, number two. Just a jacket. And the answer? It's 99.99. Okay, number three, Perla, question and answer. Uh-huh. The answer? Sorry. Okay. And number four, Danny. Briefcases, okay, with letter S, briefcases. Remember, we have two. Uh-huh. Okay, you're welcome. So that what this was the homework. Okay, well, just let's review a little bit of the vocabulary. Here I have some words. So let's see if you remember. Number one, what is it? Number one. Sweated. Perfect. Number two. Socks. Three. Watch. Four. Number five. Number six. Short shorts. Excellent. Seven. Eight. Okay. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. Some classes. 13. 14. 15. And 16. Great. Okay. Well. Let's continue here. I'm going to choose only some of these sentences, okay? Not all of them. Only some of these sentences for you. Okay, number three, guys. Tell me three items of jewelry. Three names. Items of jewelry. Rings, bracelet, one more. Necklace, perfect. Okay, let's see number four. Three things that you wear if it's cold. What do you wear if it's cold? Sweater, okay. Coat, yes. Gloves, okay. Well, you have the answer for this one, for five. Something that you put over your hands in winter. That's easy. You have the gloves, okay. Two accessories, okay? You can wear around your neck. Only two accessories. A ring. Pay attention, Perla. Two accessories that you can wear around your neck. This is your neck, Perla. This is the neck. A necklace, yes, you can wear a necklace. Another accessory that you can wear here. A scarf, perfect, okay. Number seven, three things that you wear to play sports. Sports shoes, a baseball cap. Just one more. You need one thing. You have the sports shoes, the baseball cap. One more. Okay, a uniform, okay. Let's see. Okay, let's move to number 10. Tell me three things you can wear if it's hot. shorts, yes. Top.
Mm-hmm.
Cap. Perfect. And I think that's it because it is a lot. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, and the last activity before starting with the lesson. Sí. Yesterday, we learned about the colors and we learned more vocabulary for accessories. So what you're going to do, you're going to look at the picture and you're going to complete the sentences. Okay, so I'm going to start with picture one. Okay, with this one. This is for Perla. Okay, she's wearing a purple. Here you have the answers. Boots, shorts, coat, or a scarf. So she's wearing a purple scarf. Okay. Number two, Luis, she's wearing a pink coat. Number three, Daniela, she's wearing yellow and Luis, she's wearing green. What's okay? Picture two. Perla, she's wearing an orange. Daniela, she's wearing a green. Okay, Luis, she's wearing yellow. Perla, she's wearing red. Okay, and Dani, she's wearing blue. Oops. Yes. Perla, she's wearing purple. Luis, she's wearing a pink. Okay, and Dani, she's wearing a yellow. The last one, Perla, she's wearing a blue. Scarf. Okay, Dani, she's wearing a pink coat. Okay, Perla, she's wearing white. And Luis, she's wearing purple. Puts perfect. Okay. So let's start here. Well, today we're going to continue with the lesson C. Okay, so let's go to your student book, page 80. Okay, this is the lesson C. Are you here on this page? Lesson C? Yes. Okay, correct. Okay, lesson C, it's called Can I Help You? This is conversation strategy, as you know. This is about taking time to think. Well, taking time to think. Well, it's like, for example, when someone asks you a question and you are not sure about the answer or you are thinking about your response. So we're going to learn some expressions that we can use when we need time to think of our responses. Okay, so pay attention here, okay? And these are some expressions, these two, like, well, let's see, let me think, okay? When you're, remember, when you're thinking about your answer, okay? Imagine that I ask you, how often do you go shopping? And you are like, well, let's see, I go shopping twice a month. Okay, so you're taking your time to think your response. Or let me think, I go shopping once a week. Okay, so these are some expressions that you can use when you need time to think about your answer. And these ones that are here, these are sounds, okay? They are sounds. For example, this one is when we are like, okay? It's just a sound. The second one is another sound. Okay, one more time. When you're taking time to think, sometimes we're like, okay, so they are only sounds. This one, okay, here is, uh-huh. So, for example, this one, uh-huh, is when, we're gonna use it when you want to say like, yes. For example, imagine that I ask you, okay, guys, are you paying attention to the class? And you are like, uh-huh. Okay, and Luis, did you do the homework? Uh-huh. So when you say, uh-huh, it's like you are agreeing or you're saying like, yes. Okay, that is the sound, uh-huh. And the last one, oh, when you want to show like surprise, maybe in a conversation. For example, imagine that I tell you at this moment, you know what, guys, today we're going to finish the class at 8 p.m. You're like, oh, you're like surprised because you didn't know about that information, okay? So remember the first two, they are expressions. Well, let's see, let me think, okay? You're thinking about your answer. And the rest of them, they are only sounds, okay? We have, uh-huh, oh, yes. So do you understand this part, guys? Yes. Remember, there is another way to say yes. Uh-huh. That one. Uh-huh. And this is very common. Yes. We use it a lot. Uh-huh. Okay, perfect, guys. Now, pay attention. We're going to work with these three questions, okay? We have three questions. Number one, how often do you go shopping? Two, what do you usually buy? And three, how much do you usually spend? Think of your answers, and I want you to type them. Try to use these expressions. Example, how often do you go shopping? Well, let's see. I go shopping twice a month, okay? What do you usually buy? I usually buy shoes. How much do you usually spend? Let me think. I usually spend 300 pesos, okay? Something like that. So you have your questions. Type your answers, please, and try to use some of these expressions, guys. Excellent, Luis. Correct, Perla.
tenemos en detalle accesorios.
Perfecto. $100, correcto. Only the spelling. Three is with H. And 100 is like that. Okay, you're welcome. Well, let's see. Now let's move again. We are with the lesson C. Okay, it's here. Okay, it says when you need time to think, what do you say in your language? Do you have expressions like well, what do you think? Do we use these sounds in Spanish? Like, are they very common in Spanish? Yes. And these expressions like, let's see, or let me think, are they common in Spanish? Okay, Luis says no. Let's wait for Perla and Dani. Okay, usually says how about this one? Is it common or not? Yes, this is very common. Okay. Well, here we have a brief example. It says, how often do you go shopping? Once or twice a month, maybe. Okay. So this is just an example. Now we're going to do this listening. Have a conversation. Okay, this is a conversation between Sarah and a clerk. First, I want you to look at this picture. Okay, question number one. What kind of store is this? Okay, what kind of store is this? Pay attention to the question. What kind of store is it? What kind of store is it? Yes, it's a jewelry store. Excellent, it's a jewelry store. Okay, what kind of accessories can you buy in a jewelry store? What can you buy in a jewelry store? Yes, we can buy necklaces and what else? Necklaces, earrings. Rings, yes. Bracelets, yes, bracelets. Perfect. Okay. Well, I'm gonna play the audio. Remember to, you need to put on your earphones, okay? Listen to the audio, and as you listen, follow the conversation in your books, please. Remember, this is a conversation between Sarah and the clerk, and we have a question. What does Sarah buy, and how much is it? Okay, so let's listen to this conversation.
Page 80.
Page 80.
Lesson C.
Lesson C.
Can I help you?
Can I help you?
One. Conversation strategy.
Conversation strategy.
Taking time to think.
Taking time to think.
Listen.
Listen.
What does Sarah buy?
What does Sarah buy?
How much is it?
How much is it?
Can I help you?
Can I help you?
Yes.
I'm looking for
I'm
a bracelet.
Looking for a bracelet.
All right. Is it a gift?
Is it a gift?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
It's a birthday
it's a
present,
birthday
for,
present
a friend.
For a friend.
Okay.
Okay.
And how much do you want to spend?
How much do you want to spend?
Well, let's
well,
see.
Let's see.
About $40, I guess.
$40, uh-huh. I guess.
Wow. We have
well,
these silver bracelets.
We have these silver bracelets.
Oh, this looks
oh,
nice.
This looks nice.
How much is it?
How much is it?
Let's see.
Let's see.
It's $55.95.
It's $55.95.
Oh, that's a lot.
Oh, that's a lot.
Let me think. Okay.
Okay.
I guess I'll take it.
Okay, so... Okay, well, question one. What does Sarah buy? Bracelet. Perfect. And how much is it? $40. The bracelet? Are you sure? Yes, Luis. It's $55.95. Okay, $55.95. Okay, correct. Well, as you can see here in the conversation, Sarah is using these expressions. For example, question one, can I help you? And she says, yes. So here we have a sound. Then the clerk asks a second question, is it a gift? And Sarah says, uh-huh. So we have another sound, yes. Another question, how much do you want to spend? And Sarah once again says, well, let's see. Here she's using an expression. Then we have the clerk with another sound, uh-huh. Then when Sarah asks for the price, oh, yes, we have, oh, this looks nice. So she's like surprised. She's happy, no? How much is it? We have another sound. And the clerk, one more time, he says, let's see. And he says the price, $55.95. Pay attention to Sarah's answers. Oh, that's a lot. So she is surprised. So as you can see here in the conversation, they are using a lot of expressions and a lot of sounds, okay, that you can use when you need time to think about your answers, okay? So, do you have questions about this part so far? No questions. Okay, Luis says no. How about you, Perla, Daniela? No, perfect. Okay, let's see. Okay, in exercise B, we have a pair work. It says you're supposed to work with a partner and you have to practice this conversation, but we are not able to do it. So this part, okay, B, this is gonna be your homework, okay? This is gonna be your homework. Here, you're going to send me an audio in which you are going to read this conversation. Pay attention. Here in the conversation, the person says, I'm looking for a watch, okay? I want you to change that word. Instead of saying, I'm looking for a watch, you can say, I'm looking for a camera, I'm looking for a backpack, I'm looking for a pair of sunglasses. Okay, so you're going to change that part. And here, you're going to change the price too. Well, let me think about 200 pesos, about 50 pesos, okay? So that's what you're going to do. Remember, change the underlined words. You're going to change the item. Instead of watch, you're going to use a camera, a backpack, or a pair of sunglasses, and you're going to change the price, okay? Remember, you're going to send me your audio. This is very short, okay? It's gonna take you like 5 minutes or less, something like that. Do you understand this activity? Yes, yes, correct. Thank you. Okay, so now let's move to the second page, okay? So we are here. Okay, number two, exercise two, it says strategy plus. This is about conversation sounds. This is what I explained, okay, at the beginning. It says we have two conversation sounds. Uh-huh, and oh, yes. Uh-huh means, yes, that's right, or I'm listening. Example, is it a gift? Uh-huh. So you're saying, yes, you are agreeing, okay? Number two, oh, shows you are surprised, you are happy, or you are angry. Example, this bracelet is $55.95. Oh, that's a lot. Here in this case, Sarah is surprise about the price, okay, because she thinks that it's expensive. All right, so questions about this, guys? Questions about the sounds? Uh-huh, and oh. No questions? No. Okay, correct. Well, now let's pay attention to the exercise A. It says, look at these conversations. What do the conversation sounds mean? Okay. We're going to do this. I'm going to read the conversations, and after each of them, you're going to tell me the meaning of the expressions here in the context of the conversation. For example, conversation one, we have oh, two times. Okay, I'm going to start reading, pay attention. You have some money with you, right? Let's see, I have about $60. Oh, good, can I borrow $10? Oh, not again. Okay, person A, when person A says, oh, good, what does it mean? Is the person surprised, happy, or angry? The first one reads, letter A. Oh, good. Can I borrow $10? It could be surprise or... happy. Okay, person B. Oh, not again. Angry, yes, perfect. Okay, conversation two. Okay, listen. How much do you usually spend on a sweater? About $80? Uh-huh, $70 or $80. So he, person B, is using uh-huh for what? Is he saying yes? That's right, or I'm listening. Correct. That's agreeing. Okay, conversation three. I have to go shopping this weekend. Uh-huh. I want to buy a flat screen TV. Oh, cool. So when person B says, uh-huh, what's the meaning of uh-huh? Yes, that's right. Or I'm listening. Excellent. Person B. Oh, cool. Yes. Okay, conversation four. Well, it could be also happy. Yes. Okay, number four. How many credit cards do you have? 9 or 10? Oh, that's a lot. Uh-huh, I know, but I never carry cash. Okay, so person A says, oh, that's a lot. What is the feeling? Surprise, yes. And when person B says, uh-huh, I know. Angry, are you sure? Remember, person A says, oh, that's a lot. And person B says, uh-huh, I know. That's right. Or, yes, I know. Perfect. Questions about this, guys? No? No. Okay. That's good. Well, now here in exercise three, we have a listening activity. You're going to listen to three conversations, okay? We have conversation one, two, and three. Pay attention to picture one. What do you see in picture one? What do you see in picture one? See this, you see a game. Okay, picture two, what do you see? Earrings. Necklace. And picture three. A tie and a belt. Okay, so do you have any? Do you have any of these things? Okay, Perla uses yes. What do you have, Perla? And what do you have, Luis? You have a belt. Uh-huh. Necklace and DVDs. Okay, so do you need to buy? Do you need to buy any of these things? Luis says no. No, you don't. Okay, well. Okay, as I was saying, we're going to listen to three conversations. And as you can see, we have the items, but we don't have the prices. So as you can imagine, you have to listen carefully and you're going to take notes of the prices. Okay, conversation one, how much is the game? How much is the DVD? Conversation two, how much are the earrings? How much is the necklace? Conversation three, how much is the tie? And how much is the belt? Remember, listen carefully and you're going to write down the prices. Okay, do you understand? Yes. Okay, so let's listen to the audio, please.
Page 81.
Page 81.
3. Listening. I'll take it.
I'll take it.
Listen to three conversations in the store. Write the prices of each item. 1.
Can I help you?
Can I help you?
Hello, yes.
Hello. Yes.
I'm looking for a present for my son. How much is this computer game? I want to buy him a computer game or a DVD.
Let's see. The game is $29.99.
It's on sale.
These games are usually $40.
Oh, okay. So, $29.99. And how much is this DVD?
$22.99.
So, is this computer game okay for children? I mean, a 10-year-old?
Sure. They're popular with kids from ages 9 to 90.
Okay. I'll take the game.
Two.
Hi. How much are these necklaces?
Let's see. They're 509. Oh no, sorry. They're $59.95.
They're very nice. Are they real?
Yes. And we have these earrings also.
Oh, they're very pretty.
They're $45.
Oh gosh. I like the earrings too. But the necklace is nice. Well. I guess I'll take the earrings.
Three.
Can I help you?
No, thanks.
Well,
actually, yes. I'm looking at these ties.
Yes, they're very nice. Let's see.
Wait. Here's the price. $17.50. Is that right? That's very cheap.
Yes. They're very popular.
And how about this belt?
That one? Where's the price? $179.99.
Wow. That's a lot. I'll take the tie. $17.50 is a good price. And it looks expensive.
Do you have the answers or do you want to listen again? Listening in. Okay. Here it goes again.
Page 81. Three.
Page 81.
Listening.
Three.
I'll take it.
Listening.
A.
I'll take it.
Listen to three
A.
conversations in a
listen
store.
To three conversations
write the prices
store.
Of each item.
Write the prices of each
One.
Item. One.
Can I help you?
Can
Hello.
I help you?
Yes.
Hello. Yes.
I'm looking for a present for my son.
For a present for my son.
How much is this computer game?
How much is this computer
game? I want to buy him a computer game or a DVD.
Let's see. The game is $29.99. It's on sale. These games are usually $40.
These games are usually $40.
Okay. So, $29.99.
And
how much is this DVD?
$22.99.
$22.99.
So, is this computer game
so
okay
is this
for children?
Game okay
I mean,
for children?
A 10-year-old?
I mean,
sure.
A 10-year-old?
They're popular with
sure.
kids from ages
They're
9 to 9.
Kids from ages 9
okay.
to 9.
I'll take the game.
Okay. I'll take the game.
Two.
Hi. How much are these
Hi.
Necklaces?
How much are
Let's
these
see.
Necklaces?
They're 500 and not... oh no, sorry. They're $59.95.
They're very nice. Are they real?
Yes. And we have these
yes.
earrings also.
And we have these
oh,
earrings
they're
also.
Very pretty.
They're $45.
Oh gosh. I like
gosh.
The earrings too.
But
the necklace is nice.
Well,
I guess I'll take the earrings.
I guess I'll take the earrings.
Three.
Can I help you?
Can I help you?
No, thanks.
Well, no, thanks.
Actually, yes.
Well,
I'm looking
actually,
at these ties.
I'm
yes,
these
they're
ties.
Very nice.
Yes,
and they're, only,
they're very nice.
Let's
and
see.
Only,
oh, wait.
See.
Here's the price.
Oh, wait.
$17.50. Is that right?
$17.50.
That's very
that right?
cheap.
Yes,
very
they're
cheap.
Very popular.
Yes, they're very popular.
How about this belt?
That
how about
one?
This belt?
That one?
Here's the price. It's,
price.
$179.99.
Wow, that's a lot.
Wow.
I'll take
that's
the tie. $17.50 is a good price.
$17.50
it looks expensive.
It looks expensive.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, okay, so let's check, okay, your answers. Let's start with the conversation one. Okay, conversation one, how much is the game? $29.99. Excellent. Yes, $29.99. You're correct, Luis. How much is the DVD? No. $22.99. Yes, $22.99. Remember, the game is $29.99 and the DVD is $22.99. Okay. Conversation two. How much are the earrings? No. 45. Yes, 45. The earrings. And how much is the necklace? Yes, correct. $59.99. Okay, $59.99. That's it. And number three, how much is the tie? no. Perla, Dani, no. The tie is 17.50. That's the price for the tie, 17. And how much is the belt? Excellent. $179.99. Perfect. Yes. That's the price. Okay, so let's see. I have some questions here. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, well, now let's continue with this. Let's review the things that we have learned, okay, in this unit. Okay, here I have some questions, these ones. Okay, number one is, are you wearing your favorite color? Two, do you love to shop for clothes? Three, do you usually wear jewelry? Number four, are you wearing interesting socks? And the last one, do you like to dress up in nice clothes? Okay, so let's start with question one. Are you wearing your favorite color right now? What is your answer? Okay, Perla, Daniela, what is your answer? Okay, you have the same mistake. Pay attention here. It says R. This is verb B. So, I wearing or I'm wearing. Remember. I'm wearing, yes, I'm wearing my favorite color. Okay, number two, do you love to shop for clothes? Yes, I do. No, I don't. Three, do you usually wear jewelry? Remember, for jewelry, we understand earrings, rings, watches, bracelets, necklaces. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Okay, number four, are you wearing interesting socks? Okay, Luis says, no, I'm not. And you, Perla, Daniela, are you wearing interesting socks? Okay, Okay, remember there is a short answer. Yes, I am. Okay, we don't use contractions. Yes, I am. It's a short answer. Yes, I am. Okay, the last question. Do you like to dress up in nice clothes? So do you like to wear nice clothes? Yes, I do. Excellent. Okay. So that's it. Let me see here. Okay, so I think we're almost done with the lesson. Okay, so let's do this. Remember yesterday we learned how to use this, these, that, and those. Okay, here it says we use this and these to talk about people or things that are near us. Okay, so you can touch. Okay. And we use that and those to talk about people or things that are far away. Okay, that or those. So here you're going to imagine that you are this person, okay? These things are close to you, okay? These things, but these things are far away from you, okay? These are far away from you. So here we're going to complete these sentences only with this, these, that, or those. So remember, you're going to imagine that you are this person, okay? For example, number one, we have a space. It says, shoes are black. So what is the word that we need here? It says, shoes are black. These, excellent. Number two, space. Shoes are gray. Those, perfect, is this one, okay? Three, space. Pen is small, okay? We have this one and we have this one. This, excellent. Four, space. Pen is very large. That, correct. Five, the time on space clock is 5 p.m. We have this and this. The time on space clock is 5 p.m. Yes, that clock. Six, the time on space clock is 11:50. This. Correct. Number seven, space. Plane is a toy. We have one plane here. We have another one here. That, correct, is that. Okay. Space plane isn't a toy. Yes, this plane isn't a toy. Nine, space, cat is eating. We have one cat, we have a second cat. Yes, this cat is eating. 10 space isn't eating. No, cat isn't eating. That cat isn't eating. Okay. 11. Glasses are for reading. We have this and we have this. Glasses are for reading. This. Look at this word. Glasses. Is it singular or plural? Those. Yes, plural. Those glasses are for reading. And the last one, glasses are sunglasses. These. Pay attention, Perla. One more time. Glasses. It's plural. Okay. So we have to use these or those. Okay. And here it says glasses are sunglasses. So we're going to use this. Okay. These glasses are sunglasses. Okay. So I think this is what we saw in the lesson. See, we review. Okay, well, this is the last activity for the lesson C. Okay, so do you have questions about this lesson, about lesson C? No questions. Questions. Okay. So let's see. What did you learn today? What did you learn today? The sound. This, that, this, and those. I will review one more time. Well, let's see. Had expressions. And we need time to think. We had expressions. Yes, the expressions that we need to use when we need time to think. Okay, so this was the lesson C. So how was this class? Was it easy, difficult? So tell me your opinion. Easy, okay. Luis says that the class was easy. And for you, girls, Dani, Perla. How was the class, easy or difficult? So what is that, Perla? Do you have any doubts, Perla? Yes, I know. I don't know what the problem is. I don't know if you can get maybe some speakers or something like that. Because here I have the same problem. I cannot listen very well to the audios. They are really, really low. I don't know why. That's the reason why I'm asking you to wear your earphones. Yes. I know. That's a problem. Well, let's see. Do you know how to play the handman? You know how to play handman? Okay, well, I'm gonna think of a word, and what you're gonna do, you're going to say a letter. We're going to see if you find out. So let me think of the word. Let's see. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so let's start with Luis. Tell me a letter, please. Oh, my A. Okay, Perla. Dani. Okay, Luis. What is that R? Okay, Perla. Yes, Perla. Okay, let me think of another one. Let's see. Okay, so one more time. Okay, let's start with Danny. Danny, tell me a letter. B. Okay, Luis. C. Perla. Okay, Danny. Ooh. It's not about clothes, it's not about accessories. It's another word, but it's easy. Okay, who's next? Luis? P. You're going to find out. Okay, Perla. Yes. And Danny? Yes, excellent. Oh, you're really good. Let me think another one. Let me see. Okay. Okay, go ahead, Luis. Oh. Okay, Perla. Okay, Dani. Is that E? No, it's like I. No. Okay, Luis. No, Perla. E. My mouse. Okay, Luis. That L? No. Dani? Ooh. Okay, Perla. Okay, Luis. Luis, what are you, Luis? P. Okay, Perla. Okay, Dani. It's easy. Yes, supermarket. Okay, excellent. Well, you're really good. Okay, guys. Well, let's talk about the homework. Homework. Okay, you're going to do lesson C in your workbook. Okay, we have the pages 62 and 63. Okay, pages 62 and 63 in your workbook. And also the audio for the conversation. Remember, the short conversation in the student book. And that's it. Okay, guys? Excellent. Well, okay, guys. So, see you tomorrow. Thank you for coming. Okay? And... well, have a nice evening. Take care. And remember, questions or doubts, send me a text message, please. Okay? Thanks to you. So, see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Take care. Bye-bye.